Hey guys, it's Annabelle. So welcome to Beta Day number 28, and today's Mommy Tips video is going to be on family finances. Now this is just what I have learned over the last 5 years, what works best for us, and just kind of how we do things. So when we first started talking about having a family, me and my husband were dreaming about the family that we wanted. Ever since I was little, I wanted a ton of kids. Like, I would have as many kids as my body and my husband and our life could handle. But after looking at the cost and just the whole financial situation of like where we are at and our family situation and things like that, it's just not possible to have a ton of kids anymore. With the cost of daycare, with the cost of diapers and feeding your child and clothing, and that's not even like mentioning like insurance, health insurance, life insurance, all of that kind of stuff. The cost of having kids is super expensive. So me and my husband have pretty much decided, it's still in the works of conversation and things like that, that we eventually would like there to be like 5 of us. So me and my husband and 3 kids. So we have 2 kids right now. My daughter is 2.5 and my son is 6 months old. So we have our 2 and we may be planning baby number 3 next year. And it all depends again on our finances. Our finances have a hand in almost everything that we do. Finances come into play with what all we get to do for entertainment stuff, what our kids need, if they need a new pair of shoes, how much we can put on our credit card, how much we can spend on groceries. And the budget is a big thing, and that is one of my first tips, is a budget. My second tip is to do lots and lots of research about finances. It's something that wasn't taught to me necessarily when I was growing up. I was taught about money and finances and like income and like just like bills and how to pay bills and just kind of like not spending more than what you have, but like investments and insurance and all of that kind of stuff takes research, and you have to look at things, and sometimes it's so complicated it gets confusing. So all of that kind of stuff, it takes research and it takes like setting a budget. So what we did after we found out how much it actually costs to have a child is we started looking at ways that we could do it. And that is, we found the best things for us were to, one, set a budget, set what we thought would be a reasonable amount to spend on a first kid and on a second kid for like buying what they need, buying all of the things. And so after we kind of set our budget, we kind of looked what we could do with that budget. Now, what we do personally to get rid of some of that big, huge cost of like having a family, having babies and things like that is, one, we bought a lot of things used. Second, we knew that we were going to cloth diaper. That has saved us a ton of money. My son is actually in the same diapers that my daughter was, and the only additional cost that we have with cloth diapering is we do need to purchase soap, but we should have enough for the rest of the year, so we should only have to buy that one more time while he is in diapers. And we also have to buy some cloth diaper safe diaper cream. And I actually found a cost-saving thing for that. So that should only cost us another $10 for the rest of the time that he is in diapers. Another thing is for like formula and food. For feeding babies is so expensive. So what we did is we decided that we were going to breastfeed. I pumped for my daughter. So costs for that was buying everything for my daughter and buying breast milk storage bags. The only additional cost for that, for having my son, is buying more breast milk storage bags. And we did buy new bottles, but otherwise breastfeeding and pumping and things like that has not cost us any more than our initial cost that we had with my daughter. And we do also make our own baby food. And this time around, I even found it cost saving to make our own infant cereal. And I did buy like the infant cereal that you go and you buy at the store. I bought that for my daughter. Now with my son, I did a bunch of research and found out that you can make it at home. So I made my own infant cereal, and we do make our own baby food. So that kind of cuts down on that kind of cost. And clothing, again, we buy 90% of our kids' clothes are bought used. We do buy some special occasion items brand new, and we always buy our shoes for our kids new. Just research that I've done, those are the decisions that we have made for our family. Now, again, going from baby number one with that huge cost of, again, all of those things that you have to buy, the things that you think of right off are the crib, changing table, pack and play, stroller, car seat, high chair, exerciser, swing, all of that stuff is just such a great amount. It was a little bit hard to swallow at first, but then again, we found ways that we could reduce those costs. So what we did with our son is we only had to buy a few key items, and we did buy gender neutral clothing. So we were able to use the same clothes that we did with my daughter, with my son. And we go to garage sales, yard sales, rummage sales to buy clothing for our kids. And we get great deals on nice clothes, and it's just been a huge money savings for us. So the cost for us for having kids and having a family, we have, in my opinion, been very good at sticking to our budget and not overspending where we don't need to. Again, buying used is a wonderful thing, and buying gender neutral things like gender neutral baby gear, especially if you're planning on having more than one child, is a huge break for your finances to buy gender neutral. That way you don't have to repurchase items. Where if you, like in our case, if we would have bought all pink stuff for my daughter, now the second child was a boy, so we would have had to like sell all that stuff and buy all blue stuff, or my son would just have to deal with pink stuff. But again, gender neutral is a big money savings thing. So finding a budget, sticking to a budget, and I gave some tips on how like you can like give your finances a break for having kids. And our cost for our son has been greatly lower than what it was for my daughter. We did not even spend, I think I had it figured out, we spent one eighth of the cost that we did for my daughter. And that includes labor and delivery, like hospital, medical stuff, everything. We spent an eighth in like this first 6 months of my son's life than what we did with my daughter. And that is like, it's unbelievable. Like the money savings, if you can plan ahead and prepare, which is another thing that I kind of have talked about here just previously. But just kind of how we do things is we have things automatically taken out of our paychecks as much as we can, or they are going into, the money is going into an account where bills are automatically paid out of the account. We like that, it's very simple for us, so that way we don't have 10 bills coming to our door every month. We just have two bills that actually like come to our door, and we have a couple that we have to pay on the internet. Otherwise, we have everything automatically paid as much as possible. And so the money that we have left over after all the bills are paid is what we have to spend on like gas and groceries and entertainment and things like that. And our money to spend is mostly the same every month, even going from like summer to winter. Now, our bills change by the seasons. Like our gas bill is hardly, it's hardly anything in the summertime, but it is one of our bigger bills in the wintertime. And the opposite is true for our groceries. In the spring, summer, and fall, well, the end of spring and beginning of fall, and then summer in there. Our grocery bill is quite large because we buy a lot of fresh fruits and fresh vegetables. But in the winter time, our grocery bill is very, very, very small because we don't have that fresh produce to buy because it is not the best quality in our store. And I have a really high standard for my produce. So if it's not up to my standards, then I don't buy it. So our grocery bill is quite low in the winter months. But again, our like gas bill is quite high. So it all balances out. I kind of like did a 3-year kind of figuring everything out with our finances. And everything is about the same every month. Like, I was really surprised by that. I thought with the fluctuating costs of things, but again, it all levels out. And I know that. I know how much we spend on things. I know how much I can spend on things. And that is because it has taken years to figure out our debt situation, our credit card situation, all of that kind of stuff to get to where we have been at for the last couple years. Now, it took a lot of work. It took a lot of sacrificing. We didn't do a whole lot. And all in the mix, we had our daughter and now we have our son. And it was so worth it. But again, it takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of energy and money. It doesn't make me like anxious, but it's like, okay, like I need to get this done so that I don't have to think about it for another month. So it's just something that I like to just like get off the table right away at the beginning of the month, figure everything out. I have a 6-month plan for our finances at all times to know like what expenses are coming up and what things my kids are gonna need, and just kind of trying to create a budget all around that. So I know what's coming, I know what to expect, and also having like a fund that is for emergencies is another one of my huge tips. You never know if something's gonna go wrong with your vehicle, with your water heater, with anything. Something could happen at any time where you need money very quickly. So it is always good to have that fund just in case something happens. If something happens to me and I can't work, or my husband and he can't work, or something happens to our kids or something, insurance and all of that kind of like safety net kind of stuff is so very important. And it takes a lot of research. Again, investments and all of that kind of stuff and insurance needs research and what is best for you and your family and your situation. Just with us adding my daughter to our dental insurance and like medical insurance and vision and all that kind of stuff, it all takes like working out and doing a worksheet and all that kind of stuff to figure it all out because it's so very complicated. But anyways, so those are some of my tips. Again, we try to keep things as simple as possible. If you have any questions or comments or want me to do a specific video on anything dealing with finances, please just leave me a comment below. And I will see you guys tomorrow for Veda Day number 29. Bye, guys.